For the grace you have granted us once again to look into the perfect law of liberty and to continue therein, not being a forgetful hearer but the doer of the works. We know that we are blessed in all that we do, even according to your word, in the name of Jesus. Bless everyone today that hears this message, wherever they are and abroad, be mightily touched by you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Holy Spirit, speak to us today. Recharge our lives and recharge us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for Jesus, everybody. Put your hands together for Jesus. I didn't see you put your hands together for Jesus. Amen. Today we are speaking very quickly on the mystery of submission. The mystery of submission. The mystery of submission. We are going to start from Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12. Romans is in the New Testament. Chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. Romans chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Now be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God has dealt to every man the measure of faith. John chapter 10. The gospel according to St. John chapter 10. We are reading verses 17 and 18. John 10 verse 17. Therefore does my Father love me, because I lay down my life that I may take it again. No man taketh it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. The mystery of submission. Mystery simply means secrets that are coded, which are not revealed to everyone. Coded secrets that does not show, that does not appear to everyone. It is only accessible by people that are given to know it, and to those that can think along the line. The mystery of submission. Submission comes from the word submit. to release something to put it down. To let it go from your control. To make something get out of your own jurisdiction of control. That is what we call submission. When you release something to go without your power again to control it. When your will is no longer the what matters. That is submission. That is submission. If you lele, when you release something, when it's no longer in your hand. So this day we are talking about the mystery of submission. The mystery of submission. From the scripture where we read, we will understand that this message is aimed at showing us the blessing that are in submission. The blessing or the blessedness of submitting yourself to the ease of God. When you submit yourself for God to use you, what are the blessings there in? This blessing is aimed at showing you that pouring out yourself totally for the service of God in the garden of God is very profitable. Pouring out yourself in the garden of God for the service of God is very, very profitable. Listen to me very well. The call to Christianity is a call to submission. The call to Christianity is a call to submission. To submit your life. We are called to follow Jesus Christ, who is the greatest example of submission to the will of the Father. Jesus, we follow. And he is our example of submission to the will of the Father. He is our example of submission to the will of the Father. Jesus did not do his own will, but the will of he that sent him. The worship of God is summarized in one word. The worship of God is summarized in one word, and that word is surrender. Somebody say surrender. Say surrender. The whole activity of man in terms of his worship to God is meaningful by surrendering. God wants us to surrender ourselves, our life, our time, our talent, our treasure to Him. And that is where the pain of Christianity is. We can release everything but ourselves in surrender to God. The modern day Christianity is suffering from the disease called lack of surrender. It is no longer the will of God that matters now. It is our will and wishes that matters to us. That is not what God desires of us. Except I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body as a living sacrifice to God, holy and acceptable. That is where your service will begin to make sense. Until we begin to present ourselves in absolute surrender to the will of God. Not our will, but His will. Our service
will begin to make sense.
It is then that our service will begin to make sense. But if you will not surrender for the will of God, all our singing, all our shouting, all our prayer, all our crying, all our giving, all our coming to church is in faith. That is what the Bible calls vanity upon vanity. Because the fact remains that it is our heart, which is the center of our human existence, God desires.
Amen.
So what does it mean to surrender? Surrender means that it is no longer your will, but the will of the other. Submission is to drop all yours to the will of a higher authority for final decision. When you surrender all of your own to the mercy of a higher authority, to decide and make the final decision, then you have begun to surrender. Luke chapter 22, verse 42. Luke chapter 22. Verse 42. The Bible says, saying, Father,
Baba,
if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. Not my will, but thine be done. This is where the whole task of Christianity is. How willing are we
to
surrender to the will
of God?
How willing are you to surrender that it is not what I want, it is what you want? The reason why our lives are not prospering the way it's supposed to prosper, spirit, soul, and body, is because we have refused to surrender to the will of God. We hold on to our will. If it is not my way, then it's a no-no. When God is saying, do this, you say no. This is what I want to do. How do you surrender to the will of God? God wants everybody, every man, every woman, every boy, every girl, to surrender to His will. We have an example of Jesus here. He says, Father, I don't want to go through this thing, but it is not the way I want it, but the way you want it, the way God wants it. He said, not my will, but thy will, thy own will, may God. Even when he was teaching us how to pray in Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 to 12, Isaac his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord God opened him up and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, here am I. And he said, lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing that thou hast come with her, thy son, thy only son, from God. Where we read is a typical example of submission to the will of God. Listen to me very well. Abraham was about 115 years old. The boy Isaac was about 15 years old. When a 15-year-old boy and a 115-year-old grandpa, when they contend in a race, it is obvious that the boy will outsmart the man. Isaac was very young. Was very sporty.
Was
very smart. He's versatile. He can be on the run. But his father carried him. And told him, and took him to the mountain of
Samson.
And the Bible says, his father bound him. And laid him on the altar to kill him for God. Then the Lord spoke. Abraham, don't kill him. Where we are going in this story is the mystery of submission. There is no way Abraham would have been able to sacrifice Isaac except that the boy chose to die intentionally. It is not his father that actually puts him on the altar. It is his own will to be there. That is why he was there. There is no way Abraham could have brought the boy Isaac to the altar. Except that the boy surrendered to his father. It's a practical example. Go and take your little boy, those of you that are old, and try to do anything funny with him. You will see how the boy will outsmart you. You will only be angry and you will be shouting. You, this boy, you are making me wrong. But the truth is that is brother Daride. He can outsmart me when we begin to run. Except that I'm still very young. If our father is the Lord wants to run with such a boy, there's no way we catch him. Because before he runs for 1 minute,
have
palpitation. We begin.
You
will be preaching restlessly while the boy will still be laughing. Father, come and catch me. You will be tripling the father. But what we saw the common time we are reading this story, we said Abraham sacrificed his son. Abraham sacrificed his son. The truth is, Isaac submitted himself for his father to
worship.
That is why we must understand that God will not force anybody to be on his altar. You must submit yourself by yourself. It's an intentional thing. is what you will do by yourself. God will not go and drag you and put you on his altar. It is you that will go after knowing the will of the Father and submit yourself to be used on the altar of God. God forces no man. We release ourselves. Jesus says, no man taketh it from me. I gave it by myself. I laid down my life. If Jesus did not decide to die, no way would he die. He would not have died. He would not have died. He decided that I want to die. And he released himself to die. When he was to go to Jerusalem, he told the people, he said, I am going to die. Since he knew he was going to die, if he wanted to run away, he would have run to Nigeria and hid himself, maybe in Abuja. Or maybe internet will get him there. He will go to one of those villages where there is no internet connection. And hide there. And Jesus will be about 2,000 years old now. With grey beard and be telling us stories. He decided to release himself to the will of his Father. Isaac decided to release himself to the will of his father Abraham. It was not Abraham that put Isaac on the altar. It was Isaac that surrendered himself for his father to put him there. He surrendered himself. And there is a great question. Are you ready to hear this question? Wherever you are hearing this message, listen to me. There is a question. And it is this question that propelled this message. When I was in Cameroon, one afternoon, God just ministered to me. And I had the question in my spirit. What is the question? What message do you think Isaac had that makes him to surrender himself to die? What kind of message did Isaac hear? What kind of message was preached to Isaac that makes him surrender himself on the altar to die? And the answer came in my spirit that it is not the kind of messages that most churches are preaching today. Many churches. It is not the kind of message that many of us pastors are preaching for the people. Because if it is the kind of message that we are hearing today, in most places, the body will not die. Then you are telling the boy, that your tomorrow is better. Don't allow anybody to kill you. When you are telling the boy, that you have a future, you must be better than your father. The boy, if he hears that he wants to die, what will he do? Because of his tomorrow, he will run away. He will not die. But I think the father sat him down and told him something. Abraham told Isaac something that makes him surrender to the will of God. Abraham was that when he asked his father, Baba, this is firewood. This is everything, knife. Where is the animal? His father said, God will provide. Meanwhile, after that place, there is a silence. And that side, within the silence, the father must have called him. Son, come here.
What?
sit down.
Joko.
The Bible says in Genesis 19 verse 14 that Abraham will command his children. Abraham will teach his children the will of God. 18 verse 14. Now he must have called him my son. This is how my journey with God had been. I was in Syria.
Oh, and in Syria.
When God spoke to me that I should leave this land and go to a place that He will show me. Meanwhile, it was my father,
Terah,
that God first spoke to. He did not obey. And he died. And then among the sons of my father, God chose me and spoke to me. That was how I got out. And he promised me that he would give me a son. And I worked with him perfectly for 25 years. I was 100 years old when he gave me you. Your mother was 80. In fact, my body was not working again. I was practically impotent. No more sexual stimulation for me and your mother. But the day came, God spoke that I will give birth to you. And suddenly, my body that was dead received life. Abraham told Isaac the story. And when I was 100, my mother was 90, we gave birth to you. We did not actually give birth to you. God gave you to us. God gave you to us. The boy was listening. And he now said, my son, God spoke to me that I should rise up and take you and offer you as a sacrifice to him. Since I know that he has the power, according to Romans chapter 4, to bring death back to life.
That's a move, Bruce.
He has the power. Romans chapter 4, you see there. To bring death
that is so
back to life. That is why I brought you. I know if I kill you, God knows what to do. My son, will you come to the altar? Let me kill you for God. And the son came. My father, if what you told me about this, your God is true, I surrender myself to you. Do with
me
whatever you want. He released his hand. He released his leg. His father tied him, put him on the altar, brought out the knife, and as he was to kill him, the Lord spoke from heaven. Abraham, don't kill that child. Now I know. If you read Hebrews chapter 11, the Bible says that in the heart of Abraham, Isaac was already dead, and God gave him back in resurrection. In the heart, he believed the boy has already come. And by the time he was going back home with the boy, it was a type of the resurrection of Jesus that was to come. That when he dies, he will live again. The mystery of submission. The message he had was a serious message. And he surrendered himself to the will of his father. And the Bible makes us understand that Isaac represents Christ. That mountain, Moriah. is debated today among theologians. That it is connected to the mountain of Calvary. Where the Lamb of God died.
Abraham
represented God. Isaac represented Jesus. Abraham brought the son. The son surrendered upon the mountain. And he died. When he died, he lived again.
He's
alive forevermore. He's alive forevermore. No man taketh it from me. I give it out by myself. Listen to me, my people. You must surrender.
What is your war?
To the will of God.
See if you're alone.
If your life is going to make meaning in the sight of God.
You draw alone.
Surrender. Not my will.
This is very me.
But the will of God. Not the way I want it.
This is much fair.
In everything. In everything. Not the way I want it. But the way you want it,
okay.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. 2 Corinthians. Chapter 8. I'm going to bring it to a close with these Bible quotations.
2 Corinthians.
Chapter 8. Verses 2 to 5. 2 Corinthians. Chapter 8. Verses 2 to 5. The Bible says, how then in a great trial of affliction, the abundance of their joy and their deep poverty abounded unto the riches of their liberality. For to their power I bear record, yea, and beyond their power, they were willing of themselves. Praying us with much entreaty, they were begging us that we would receive the gift and take upon us the fellowship of the ministering of the saints.
Verse 5,
listen very well. And this they did, not as we hoped, but first gave their own selves to the Lord and unto us by the will of God.
Àti èyí kìí ṣe bí àwa ti lò lórí ṣùgbọ́n wọ́n tètè kọ́ fi ara wọn ti kára wọn fún Ọlọ́run àti fún wa nípa ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
The Bible said they were willing of themselves.
Àwọn fẹ́ láti inú ara wọn.
And they gave themselves.
Wọ́n sì jọ̀wọ́ ara wọn.
First to God.
Ọmọ Ọlọ́run.
And to the church.
Àti
they gave themselves.
Ọmọ ara wọn.
God is looking for people.
Ọmọ
that will give themselves.
Ọmọ ara wọn.
For the, his will.
For
his work. For his assignment. Will you be one? Will you be one? They gave themselves to God. They laid it down. This matter is a matter of how willing are you? Are you forced to do the work of God? It has no reward. If you are forced to do the work, it has no gain. But when you surrender, willingly, it's not because I don't have another place to go. It's not because I don't have another thing to do. But I have decided to follow Jesus. No coming back.
Then
there will be a reward. The mystery of submission is the secret of increase.
And multiplication. If you are going to increase, if you are going to be multiplied in God, in all good things, in the sight of God, you must submit yourself. Read two Bible quotations before we go. John chapter 12, verses 24 and 25. John chapter 12. Verses 24 and 25. Listen very well. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it dies, it bringeth forth much fruit. He that loveth his life shall lose it. And he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto eternal life. Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 5. And verse 7. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 5, and verse 7. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou would not, but a body hast thou prepared me. Then said I, verse 7, Lord, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me, to do thy will, O God. I come. How many of us are ready?
You want to say to do that is
the will of God.
If you are alone,
raise your hand.
Now what? It's okay.
I'm ready.
Prayer.
Lord, I'm ready to do your will. Your will alone. Your will only. Go ahead and pray. I come to do your will. Lord, your will. Your will. Before we close this, we are going to sing this song. Let the instrument be, the instrumental be on the instrument, please. Baba ye, Jackie John, Barrede.
Mary, 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 M
That the grace, the fortitude to submit to the will of God, come what may, let that grace fall upon you. I didn't hear your loud amen. Let that grace fall upon you.
Amen.
Everyone under the sound of my voice, the power to do the will of God, the way God wants it, receive it now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The hand of God will rest upon you.
Amen.
You will walk in the light of God.
Amen.
And every blessing that is in the will of God, I ask that they manifest in your life quickly.
Amen.
You will walk and you will not faint.
Amen.
You will not fall.
Amen.
You will not fail.
Amen.
You will not fumble.